can get it done.
Turn up, our man.
Coming in this time
the
the point, right behind Kissler and Slater, right behind Russell and Grill. Big Bro Wood in that third row, Oak County Mount, along with Chip Chubb. Long way to go, six down, 34 laps to go.
Long way still to happen here tonight. Like I said, nothing's going to be settled, trust me on this deal. But right now, Darren Hayes likes the way he feels up on the front of the field as he'll come around. You'll see Bruce Gordy first in the bike stand. Bring him up to speed. Green flag in air. Problem.
Thank you.
Canada, they can run a top 10 skinny girl now.
Sharon Hayes, the horn car, is your leader. But it looks like Timothy Brown, just like a good hunter, stalking his prey, trying to figure out where he's strong and where he's weak, so he can make out that.
Well, I guarantee you, like I said, Timothy Brown, he picked up a big win, a factory stock win, a few weeks ago at the West Plains Motor Speedway. No, check that. Batesville Motor Speedway. And it was a big factory stock show, and he's one of the hard contenders to deal with in a factory stock. And he's definitely one that's not far out of victory circle as we speak. He could definitely be one to get the job done. This yellow flag is going to help Pearl Woods a lot in that. Also, it's going to maybe recover a little bit of spot there for Darren Kritzler. Kritzler tonight, of course, he went back to fifth for second on the start. Chip Shattuck still in the top 10 as he's shown back there at ninth now. And Kenny Carroll has also snuck up in the 10. Like it's going to come back on the track. Barry Daniels hit the hot pits over there. They'll come back out and join with us now. That 32 car. Double final start coming back. I said it's 17 or 16 lap interval. Then they go back to the last complete lap.
Yellow goes out. Ready to go. Green flag racing out of turn number four. This time, speaking of horns, it is your leader, Jared Hayes, the horn car. Right behind is the one of Jeremy Russell. And the 11, what 11 that is, of Timothy Brown. Here they come, looking for green. Thank you. Jeremy Russell, the Cape One car, your leader, definitely not wanting to see a caution come out. As he was riding a good cushion with about a five-car length lead over the Ford of Hayes. Now, it's going to be bunching them back up. He'll be taking off again. Let's see if he can maintain that.
I tell you what, Jam, take your hand over to the Hayes machine there in that four car, Jared Hayes. He has held every bit of ground there tonight so far, not give up none. I think if Timothy Brown earned every inch he can make in that 111 car. Derek Chrysler started second. He's in fourth. Chrysler has put together a great race package over the last few weeks. And to end up the year with a car this fast is very good for him. And it looks like 2016 can only be better for that 9 car.
The G1 of Tony Anglin, the Walnut Ridge, Arkansas native, started on that row number 7. He has moved up, looking to take that 5th spot away from Burl Wood. He's working on him hard.